I say, morning, world, how's everyone doing? It's been a while since we spoke. I'm coming to you live from the OT page today. And I just want to take a moment to ask you, do you own your struggles? Do you own your letdowns? Do you own your disappointments? Do you own your mistakes? Or are you one of those ones that make excuses and point the fingers at the world, at the universe, and other people for your letdowns, your struggles, your mistakes, your disappointments? Are you one of them people? If you are, I'm gonna encourage you to change today, because it's enough people out here pointing fingers and pointing, playing a blame game for other people, well, to other people for their mistakes in life. Enough is enough. You have to wake up and start owning your life. You gotta own all the good, the bad, the indifference in your life in order for things to change. Yeah, it's quick to make a post, to be subliminal, to make it seem like other people are the problem for your mistakes or your letdown. But do you ever once stop and think, maybe I'm the reason for my own letdowns, my mistakes, my disappointment? Maybe I'm the reason that I'm not getting promoted, I haven't made enough money, I'm not living the life that I was designed to live. But most people don't want to go into that I format. It's easier for them to say, well, you know, such and such, it's on them, it's on other people. It's always easier to look out at the world and blame the world than it is to hold up a mirror and look back at yourself and see what the real problem lies. Most people don't want to go into those dark corners, get into those dark closets, and have that one-on-one conversation with themselves and let them know and talk to themselves and beat themselves down. But they're quick to beat down others. Think about that. We're quick to beat down others, but you don't want to beat down yourself because you know the feeling that truly lies inside of you. Enough is enough. You need to go and have that one-on-one conversation with yourself. You need to go beat yourself down. Give yourself, beat yourself down, make yourself cry, then forgive yourself. Then after you do that, then you go to God with your request and ask God to start helping you heal from the inside out. Last night, Big Sean made a post to let everybody know he was suffering from anxiety and depression. I have told people along this journey that money don't always equate to happiness. When you start losing everything around you that once formed you and made your core, money is just money. Money is nothing more than, it's a dollar, it's a piece of paper. You rip it, you throw it away. It can help you in life. It can help you get better things in life. But even those better things don't make you happy in life. A lot of people not realizing that. So it's a lot of people out here saying, Terrell, I want $20 an hour, I want $30 an hour. Cool, go get it. But on your journey to get that 20 or that 30 or that 40 or get up here into those hundreds, it's a process that you must stay real with yourself. You may stay honest with yourself and keep those people around you that need to be around you. I told people before, everybody that come on this journey with you won't stay on this journey with you. Some people are meant to get tossed off the boat or get left on an island or get left on side of the road, because the more you grow and the more they stay the same, the more toxic things become. If you ever had something like a protein shake, if you let it sit for a while, it separates. Orange juice, you let it sit, it separates. So you got to shake it back up to get it to form again. However, with that, you need to understand, once you leave those people, that don't mean you forgot about them. It just meant this journey wasn't for them. Now, once you realize that, you got to realize what was the source of that problem. Come back to yourself. Talk to yourself and say, what went wrong between me and that person? If you find out that you was the root cause, call that person, text them, email them, do whatever, and apologize, but continue to move forward. It's a lot of relationships in my life that I had to mend through to just saying, I forgive you, but I had to forgive myself first because I see I hurt you and I'm sorry. But there's no need for us to rehash the past. Let's just leave it at that. It's people in my life I don't talk to. I forgive you, but I don't have to talk to you anymore. It's a big difference. I love you from a distance, but there's no need for us to be in the same room. There's no need for us to talk anymore, because there's no need for us to go back down that journey of us both hurting each other again. Now, if you're going to own your struggles and your mistakes and everything in your life, just own it. Once you own it, things become better. Things become easier to cope with. Once you own it, you must take extreme ownership of your life. And once you do that, this world and this universe becomes yours. No one else can hurt you. No one else can down talk you once you own your mistakes. But the problem is, most of us looking out for self-gratification. The likes, the reshares, the attaboys and attagirls, most people are looking outwards. Enough is enough. Stop looking outwards and look inwards first. As a child, You always look to yourself. You had an imagination, like SpongeBob said. You had that imagination. You saw the world different. But as you grow older, your imagination starts to shrink, and you become conformed to what people in this world, in this society, tell you you should be or what you could be. And you accept that. You look to your left, you look to your right, and start asking people, you think they right? Yeah. They're not right. If inside your heart of hearts, you know you was designed for more, go get more. Realize it. It ain't easy. As David Goggins said, this world is unbiased. Everyone would die. From the moment you take your first breath, everyone would die. So the world is not biased. The world didn't discriminate against you. Yes, you may be dealt a bummy hand, but guess what? You play it. Some people play the most bummiest hand until they figure out the game. You can have the worst hand in Texas Hold'em and still win the game if you know how to play the game. Life is nothing more but a big game. You must realize your position in this life and play it to the best of your capabilities. Once you play it to the best of your capability, you will master that. And once you master it, no one else can tell you anything. So here today, you guys own your mistakes in life. Go look at yourself in the mirror, go in a closet, beat yourself down, pick yourself back up, beat yourself back down, cry about it, do whatever. It's okay to cry, man. It's okay. Get that toxicity out your life and cry about it, but then do me a favor, be man enough to go to God with your problems and pray about it, or whoever you pray to, whatever you worship, go to them and seek that guidance so you can move forward in life. It's a lot of people scared to move forward because they haven't healed yet. They're covering it with material things that eventually those material things start to degrade and start to fade away. So y'all be great today. Love you all.